Oh, praises to Ahayah, sure, Ahayah, Bahashem, Yeshaya, Wonk, Wonk. This is Shabar Israel, and today I'd like to speak on the topic of the Most High pouring out His Spirit on His handmaids. I will be reading Genesis, Joel, and the book of Acts, and it reads, "And the sons of Zilpah, Leah's handmaid, Gad and Asher, these are the sons of Jacob, which were born to him in Paddan Aram." Now, we know that Genesis 49:19, a truth shall overcome Gad, but he shall overcome at the last. I am from the tribe of Gad, and I am a seer, as my foreparents were. And you can find that in the book of Chronicles. Now, as we can see here that Zilpah was Leah's handmaid. I'm not going to get into the genealogy. The Bible says that you should not strive in such. Nevertheless, I am a descendant of Israel, and he's my forefather. As I stated before, Genesis 49:19, the troop shall overcome Gad, he shall overcome at the last. And notice the word there, handmaid. Now, let's go to the book of Joel, the second chapter, and it reads, "Blow ye the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Most High cometh, for it is nigh at hand, a day of darkness and of gloominess, a day of clouds, of thick darkness, as the morning spread upon the mountains, a great people and a strong. There have not been ever the like, neither shall be any more after it, even to the years of many generations. A fire devoureth before them, and behind them a flame burneth. The land is a garden of Eden before them, and behind them a desolate wilderness. Yea, and nothing shall escape them. The appearance of them is as the appearance of horses and of horsemen, so they shall run. Like the noise of chariots on the tops of the mountains shall they leap, like the noise of a flame of fire that devoureth the stubble, and a strong people set in a battle array. Before their face the people shall be pain. All faces shall gather blackness. They shall run like mighty men. They shall climb the wall like men of war. And they shall march every one on his ways. And they shall not break their ranks. Neither shall one thrust another. They shall walk every one in his path. And when they fall upon the sword, they shall not be wounded. They shall run to and fro in the city. They shall run upon the wall. They shall climb up upon the houses. They shall enter in at the windows like a thief. The earthquake before them, the heavens shall tremble, the sun and the moon shall be dark, and the stars shall withdraw their shining. And the Most High shall utter his voice before his army, for his camp is very great, for he is strong that executeth his word. For the day of the Most High is great and very terrible, and who can abide in it? Therefore also now saith the Most High, turn ye even to me with all your heart, and with fasting, and with weeping, and with mourning, and rend your heart and not your garments, and turn unto the Most High your power, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and of great kindness, and repenteth him of the evil, who knoweth if he will return and repent and leave a blessing behind him, even a meat offering and a drink offering unto the Most High of power. Blow the trumpet in Zion, sanctify a fast, call a solemn assembly, gather the people, sanctify the congregation, assemble the elders, gather the children and those that suck the breast. Let the bridegroom go forth out of his chamber, and the bride out of her closet. Let the priests, the ministers of the Most High, weep between the porch and the altar, and let them say, spare thy people, O Most High, and give not thine heritage to reproach, that the heathen should rule over them. Wherefore should they say among the people, where is their power? Then will the Most High be jealous for his land, and pity his people. Yea, the Most High will answer and say unto his people, behold, I will send you corn and wine and oil, and ye shall be satisfied. And I will no more make you a reproach among the heathen, but I will remove far off from you the northern army, and will drive him into a land barren and desolate, with his face toward the east sea, and his hinder part toward the utmost sea. And his stink shall come up, and his ill savor shall come up, because he hath done great things. Fear not, O land. Be glad and rejoice, for the Most High will do great things. Be not afraid, ye beasts of the field, for the pastures of the wilderness do spring. For the tree beareth her fruit, and the fig and the vine do yield their strength. Be glad then, ye children of Zion, and rejoice in the Most High your power, for he hath given you the former rain moderately. He will cause to come down for you the rain, the former rain, and the latter rain, and the first month. And the floor shall be full of wheat, and the fats shall overflow with wine. And I will restore you to the years that the locusts have eaten, the cankerworm, and the caterpillar, and the palmer worm, my great army which I sent among you. And he shall eat in plenty, and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Most High your power, that hath dealt wondrously with you, and my people shall never be ashamed. And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and that I am the Most High your power, and none else, and my people shall never be ashamed. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your old men shall dream dreams, and your young men shall see visions, and also upon the servants and upon the handmaids. In those days will I pour out my spirit. That is Joel 2, verses 1 through 29. Here we have the day of the Most High, and he's telling the children of Israel to sound an alarm. Many can relate this to 70 AD. You can relate the day of the Most High to events of magnitude such as 70 AD. But notice that it talks about the bride and the bridegroom. We know that in the book of Revelations, it tells us that the bride has made herself ready for the bridegroom. And this is the same scenario that is going on in this chapter. And then we continue to read, and it stated that he will pour out his spirit upon his servants and his handmaids. Now, we just read that Leah, handmaid, was Zilpah, and she brought forth Gad. And that I'm from the tribe Gad. It states that the Most High here is going to pour out his spirit even on the handmaids. I'm still a child of Israel. So let's look at that word handmaid and see what it means. Comes from the Strong 8198. And it means bondmaid, servant, as belonging to a mistress of a dress, speaker, humility, figuratively speaking. So is not the children of Israel in bondage right now? Is it the handmaids in bondage right now?